Hello guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So this is your new video for March 1st and the people who are coming for the first time, I would like you guys to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that you don't miss out on the new videos that we upload on our channel. So guys, this is our Telegram group where you can directly ask your queries to us, or you can also enjoy the free quizzes that we provide on this group. So if you want to join this group, then the link is in description below. So guys, this is our new course that we have launched, the 2022 course, and I will be taking you through the course, through the benefits that we are offering in this course in a quick manner. So within 5 seconds I will complete the entire course. So let's begin, and then we will begin the video with the first current affairs question. So guys, here is the first pamphlet or the first offering from our side, and that is the mock test. So you will get phase 1 mock test, you will get phase 2 mock test, 10 phase 1 mock test, 10 for finance and management, 10 for ESI, 10 for English descriptive, as well as you will get the assistance for interview preparation. Now guys, since you know that RBI has changed its pattern, so we have also changed our pattern of preparing the mock test as well as the documents. So these mock tests are being prepared by keeping the new pattern in our mind, and therefore these mock tests will be very helpful for you in your preparation for the upcoming RBI Grade B examination. Apart from this, video lessons and downloadable PDFs. So this is the same feature that we have offered since years to our students. So this is the new package, new perk that you will get after enrolling in this course. So you will get a book bundle that will include phase 1 question book, phase 2 question book, phase 2 revision booklet, phase 1 and 2 past year papers that will be from 2010 onwards to 2020, and notebook and pen. So these are the books that we will send you at your place if you enroll in this course. Now guys, if you are willing to enroll in this course, then you can use this 30% discount that we are running on this course by using the RBI30 coupon code. Or if you have any queries related to the course, then you can call on this number. Okay, so let's begin our current affairs with this first question. Recently, IRDAI formed Janakiram working group to review its cyber security guidelines. When were the said guidelines issued by IRDAI? So IRDAI stands for Insurance Regulatory Authority of India. Now it has formed a working group headed by Janakiram, who is the chairman of the chairman of Institute for Development and Research in Banking Technology, and he has been appointed as the chairperson of this working group that has been recently formed by IRDAI to review its cyber security guidelines. Now, when were these guidelines issued? These guidelines were issued in 2017, and under these guidelines, various mandates like forming a committee for cyber security, forming a policy, these kinds of mandates are given to the insurers by this IRDAI. So that is all for this question. There is nothing much that you should memorize for your phase 1 examination. Now guys, who is the chairman of IRDAI? It's Subhash Chandra Khuntia. So he is the chairman of IRDAI. That is very important that you should remember. Now, where is the head office of this organization? This is your question that you are going to tell me in the comment section below. Okay, so we have the new GDP forecast. What is India's GDP forecast for FY22 for India? So this is somewhat sad for all of us because we have just covered the GDP forecast by taking those as the final GDP forecast. But since India has released its revised GDP forecast, as well as Moody's has also released its revised GDP forecast, therefore we should update ourselves. Okay. So what is the new GDP forecast for FY22? First of all, FY22 stands for 2021 to 2022. Now, Indra has forecasted 10.4% GDP growth rate for the year 2021 to 2022, and for this year the contraction is 7.8%. So these are the two GDP growth rates that you have to mug up for the upcoming examination, and let's keep our finger crossed that no other agency would change its GDP forecast in the coming days, otherwise it will be a cram up for all of us. But you guys don't have to worry about the GDP forecast updates, because these updates are being provided to you through the Spotlight magazine, as well as I will revise the GDP forecast document as well with the new update. So you can take that document as the final document, because I will update these new updates given by the agencies. Okay, so let's discuss the next question. What is Moody's GDP forecast for India for FY22? So it's again 13.7%, and for the current year the GDP is -7%. Next, who is the president of Table Tennis Federation of India? So you have Arvind Kumar, Dushyant Chautala, Sanjay Bajpai, Nivedita Verma and Ajay Kumar. Out of these, Dushyant Chautala, who is at present Haryana's deputy chief minister, he has been reappointed as the president of Table Tennis Federation of India. That's all. It's a very simple appointment question, therefore we don't need to delve into the details of this Table Tennis Federation of India. Just remember Dushyant Chautala, who is at present Haryana's deputy chief minister as well. Okay, so guys would be wondering here, who is this beautiful woman? You will get to know this after we discuss this question. So who has been appointed as the goodwill ambassador of this United Nations Population Fund? So basically, she is the person who has been appointed as a goodwill ambassador of United Nations Population Fund. What is the name of this person? So the name is Natalia Vodinova, and she's from Russia. So this is again an important fact. Natalia Vodinova, and she's from Russia, and she has been appointed as the goodwill ambassador for United Nations Population Fund. When was this fund formed? When was this fund created? That is your question for the day. Next, who has been appointed as the chairman of the National Commission for Scheduled Caste? So you have the five options. Out of these, Vijay Sampla is the right answer. So Vijay Sampla has been appointed as the president of this National Commission for Scheduled Caste. Now guys, under which article of the Constitution does this National Commission for Scheduled Caste mentioned, or the functions of this commission has been defined? So it is Article 338. Do remember this thing, because that question can be asked. And I remember that some other day someone was asking me that, are the articles of Constitution important for you guys to remember for the RBI examination? So guys, again, this article is important. I had told you that the articles which are in news are important. So the news is the appointment, but since this commission is in the news, therefore it can be asked from you that under which article of Constitution does this commission is mentioned, or the functions of this commission are provided. So it is Article 338. Now, my question from you is that, who appoints the chairperson of this commission? Who appoints this chairperson? This is your question that you have to tell me in the comment section below. Who has become the first female celebrity to become the face of the Levi's brand in India? So who wears Levi's would know that it is an American denim brand. So remember this thing, it's American denim brand. And recently, an actress has been appointed as its global ambassador, who is representing this brand as the first female ambassador of this brand in India. Now, who is that person? It is Deepika Padukone. In how many categories was the 10th National Award for Technology Innovation in Petrochemicals and Downstream Plastic Processing Industry given? So basically, this award was given by Minister of Chemicals and Fertilizer. And who is that minister? This you will tell me in the comment section below. Now, these awards were given in order to recognize the efforts of people in the field of petrochemicals and basically petrochemicals and plastic processing. In how many categories were these awards given? It is 4. So the first category is innovation in polymeric materials. These are the winners and they all belong to this organization. Then we have innovation in polymeric products. 4 winners. The institution is this. Next, these are the 2 other categories, innovation in polymer processing machinery, equipment and robotics and automation. So this is the winner, this is the organization itself. Therefore, that block is blank. So next is polymers in medical and pharmaceutical applications. So this one is the winner and he belongs to this institution. So that's all, guys. I hope that you have enjoyed the session, and if you have, then do share it with your friends, do give us a thumbs up and subscribe our channel. Thank you so much for watching the video.